numerator term. When I am writing t in numerator term, then what will happen? Lt minus 2. Clear? The dimension formula of the acceleration, Lt minus 2. Now, move towards the force. Force, in 9th class, you read about the force formula, that is in Newton's second law. F is equal to ma. M is the mass. So, simply replace the M by capital M. Okay? Mass by capital M. Because dimension of the mass is, symbol is capital M. I am replacing the M by capital M. And A. What is the dimensional formula of the A? I already derived the dimensional formula of acceleration. That was Lt minus 2. Okay? So, as I already defined in definition, the dimension formula of the force is mLt minus 2. Then I have derived the dimension formula of the force, that is mLt minus 2. Now I think it's clear by you. At that time when I defined dimension formula, you are not clear how this formula can be derived. Now this is clear by you how I can derive the dimension formula of the force, that is mLt minus 2. And you have to cram some formulas. For if you want to increase the speed, then you have to cram some dimension formulas, basic dimension formula. Suppose force, pressure and acceleration to derive the another physical formula, dimension formula. So you have to cram. So, next time I will ask dimension formula of force is mLt minus 2. Okay. Now, pressure. I written in the expression dimension formula of pressure is ml minus 1 t minus 2. Now, I am deriving the formula of the pressure. You know the formula of pressure. Pressure is equal to force upon area. And dimension formula of the force is mLt minus 2. I am replacing the force by dimension formula of the force, mLt minus 2. And area, the dimension formula of the area means area is equal to length into breadth, and length and breadth both are lengths. So, I am replacing length and breadth by L square. So, what will happen if this 2 goes the numerator term, then what will happen? It becomes L minus 2. So, L1 and minus 2. Powers kya hogi? Then simply minus 1. 1 minus 2 becomes minus 1. So, formula becomes ml minus 1 t minus 2. This is the dimension formula of the pressure. And one important thing, always write the dimension formula in the square brackets. Clear? Because I have written all the dimension formula in the square brackets. This is the rule for the dimension formula. You have to write the dimension formula in the square brackets. Clear? Now, you can derive the dimension formula of the other physical quantity. I have given the list of 62 formulas. Then you can derive the dimension formulas of all the physical quantity step by step. And some of the physical quantity dimension formula you can cram. Okay. Now, we have four quantities. I am expressing how in terms of dimension formula we can divide the physical quantity into four classification. We have four classification. First classification is dimensional variables. Second is dimensionless variables. Third is dimensional constant. And fourth one is dimensionless constant. How we can define in terms of dimension formula these four classification? Listen carefully. If I am talking about dimensional variables, variable means they can vary. Any physical quantity that can vary is called the variable. But it is dimensional. It has some dimensions. If we talk about the area, if we talk about the volume, velocity, force, they all are variable quantities. Because for any means area is always variable term, but it has some dimensions. Okay, means area dimensions, I have already told you the dimension of the area is L square. So dimensions of the area is L square, but it is a variable quantity, means area of any quantity of vary. Okay, means if I am taking the any square, rectangle, any polygon, then area of these total terms are vary, but but area dimensions are always l square. So it is a dimensional variable, vary kar raha hai, but it has some dimensions. Next we have dimensionless variables. Variable hai, but they don't have dimensions. Means if we talk about the angle formula is arc upon radius. Arc is also length and radius is also length. So length by length, no unit. Okay, so no unit means no dimensions, but it has variable means angle always vary for any quantity. Angle vary, but it has no dimensions. Suppose if I'm talking about the relative density formula is any density of the substance. Suppose I'm calculating the relative density of the substance, then I'm simply divide the density of the substance by density of water at 4 degrees Celsius. So density has some dimensions, but if we divide a density by density dimension formula, then what will happen? No dimensions is there. So relative density has no dimensions. Okay, so it is called a dimensionless variable. Relative density vary from substance to substance, but it has no dimensions. So it is called the dimensionless variables. Okay, clear? I think